going on, guys? Welcome back to another video on the channel. Today we are playing some Woodmill Inc, and actually it's taken a while to load, but it's fine. What happened was, yesterday it was my day off, and the only day off for a while, so I was going to literally sit down and make loads and loads of YouTube videos, but by the time I uploaded one, YouTube broke, so the thumbnails throughout the morning wouldn't work, and then they fixed and uploaded a video straight away. And then the Xbox, like, oh, what the hell? Oh no! Yeah, so basically, I'll explain it all to you now. Basically, the Xbox, right, what happened with the Xbox is the Xbox Live systems, like on the Xbox Microsoft end, that went down, like, kaboom, major outages and everything. Couldn't play games, couldn't edit your profile. Xbox was just broken. So I was like, okay, didn't worry me because I had PC. I just played PC for the rest of the day and didn't make any YouTube videos. But I'm back now. We are back on. But it's happened again. I've lost my trousers. But the real reason why I've lost my trousers this time is because I was actually showing Akoza, one of the devs, I think one of the devs, I'm not sure if it was Akoza or someone else, could have been Luckfire or someone else, but someone said in the Woodmill Discord, you can get refunds for item, this is actually an item of clothing, by the way, and I was told that you can get a refund for this. I have no idea where you'd be able to get a refund, but I'm on Xbox, we're gonna give it a little check on Xbox, see if the menus are different. But we're gonna go change the skin anyway before we get back into the video, because I don't want to be bottomless throughout the entire video. So let's go to avatar and we'll go to edit avatar. So what you see here is all of the skins that I have, and when you press Y to what is that? What the hell? That's not me, and I've not seen that before. But if we go on to customize, that's what we want. And we want to go on to clothing and then pants. That's all we need. And then you will see that there are like four of them that don't want to load. And that this one is the one that I currently have, which is, I don't think it, no, it's not. I think it's this one. Ah, I have no idea. Is it this one? Is it going to, you know what? I think it is this one. Yeah, I think it's this one. I have two. I have three. Like, three different gold styles of trousers, pants, whatever you want to call them. So, they all do look good. And I like them. What about the blue one? Blue isn't our style. They're ripped. Wow. Okay. We've got red one as well. We've got a red one here. And we've got... we'll stick with this one. You know what? No, we wanted the one with the crown. If it's not correct, then we'll come back and change it back in the future. But that is hopefully correct. And let's go back into Woodmill Inc. And also there's this thing as well, which is Test 2. It's 1,000 Robux. I can't play it. I've not even got it favorited and it's on my favorites. And what about Woodmill Inc? It's not even favorited either. Let's take it off my favorites. There we go. That's better. Right, let's jump back into Woodmill Inc. Okay, so before we get into this video, I'm already 10 minutes into recording and we've literally only got like 3 minutes worth of video footage here. But Cluckfire, whatever you want to call them. I think that they were called Cluckfire before. I think now they changed the name to Luckfire, and it could be changed to something else in the future. But this is what they say. I'll try and put a screenshot up on screen. But they say, quick question, which one of these look nicer, left or right? Well, I think the right side looks a lot better because it just looks eye-catchy, more solid, like user-friendly. When you're looking at the menus, it looks friendly and it doesn't look like it's sticking out at you being wobbly. So basically, my response to that message was the left side basically looks like it's tilted to the right. That's just my opinion, which it kind of does. It just looks like it's sticking out at you. 3D. It's like the other menus are not, like the hotbar doesn't look like that. The hotbar is not, buttons will actually look like buttons, they say. Yeah, but does the hot bar look like it's sticking out at you, though? No. Like, different from everything. I mean, yeah, it's your choice, devs, but... yeah. Okay, well, we're gonna get straight into this video. I'm gonna just go off the chat now, because, I think that's the end of that convo. I think they've had enough of my input. I don't think they're gonna add what I wanted. But we're gonna load it in, and is it becoming daytime? I mean, nighttime? I think it's becoming nighttime. Ah, oh, it sucks. What we're gonna do is, you know what? Yeah, we'll load here. We'll go get some birch wood today. Ooh, what's this? What's going on here, huh? Is this a maze? Are you making a maze? Oh my god, this is so good. Okay, right. This is what we're gonna do, guys. This is what we're doing. Would you like to teleport? No. Right, this is where we're gonna start here. I presume this is where you're gonna start, and we're gonna do this maze. Oh my god. Okay, let's go this way. You know what? I'm not really sure if it's a maze now, because it doesn't look like there's many dead ends. Bit concerned. Oh wait, no, there is a dead end. We've reached a dead end. Okay, so it is a good maze. It's a good maze. Oh, it's only half completed. Is that a watermelon? Someone's got a little thing that looks like a it's on fire! It's a watermelon pooping fire. This base is cool. I like this base. Congratulations, dude. But yeah, this keep going. You're Snow Perks Papa. That's how I'm gonna say your name. But yeah, it looks cool. I like it. Of the maze. I like the design. Yeah, it just looks better. But you know what? We're gonna go over to the land store, and we are going to buy ourselves a piece of land, because we have 127,000, so therefore we should probably go and get ourselves a piece of land, right? Would just make sense. How much would the land cost? I have no idea, because I think the last one was like 21,000. Not too sure. Let's go have a look. 18,000. Okay, so that's cheaper than I thought. But where can we place it? Can we place it... I want to try... Okay, so we can't place it where I was going to place it before. As in, like, where the... The only place where it's not been. Like, on the right side where it... Literally where it is now, but below it. That's where I wanted to put it. I can't put it there for some reason, but it looks like we're going to have to place it here. And, yeah, we'll just deal with that. 109,000 left. It's annoying that we don't get teleported back to our slot, because I think there should be a teleport feature inside of the land store, you know? Just another guy that's like, hey, just another guy that's inside of there, just on the sidelines, sat on a chair, being like, hey, I'll give you a tour around or something, or hey, I'll give you a little lift to your base for a fee of $50 or something. I don't know, but yeah, it's really far to walk. It is a really long way to walk. Okay, we're here, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna go get ourselves a load of birch trees, because we need a lot of birch trees. Yeah, we need birch trees, that's for sure. We have an entire new section now, that's so great. But, oh yeah, outside of episodes, I built my base a little bit more. So if we go upstairs, you can see that this thing is done. I'm not sure if I've shown this on video, but this is done. I've done this barrier here. It looks all good. That's basically saying, the stairways are completed. This stairs is completed. It's all done. Right, now we just need to focus on alpha axes, building shelves, and stuff like that. But as I can't place another one here, I presume this is the end of the land, so we can only expand out that way. Which is alright, so we can build another door like here or something? Probably about here. And we can have like a back garden conveyor area maybe. I'm not too sure, but I don't know if I should have my house here permanently, or if I should extend it on, or maybe in the future when there's more stuff added into the game, I'll just make an entirely new slot, and then everything on this slot will be permanently saved. Permanently. And now people have dropped off a couple signs to my base as well, which is right here. We've got Alex's sign as well. I did say in loads of videos, don't sell your signs. And these people, I presume they were going to sell their signs anyway. If you're going to sell your signs, then feel free to give them me. But just don't give them me in videos, because I don't want to be given anything, to be honest. But if I'm on PC, you can ask me if I want your sign. And I'll say, yeah, sure. But just don't give me stuff randomly. Just ask me first. And preferably if I'm on PC too, because I do play PC. Like yesterday, I was on PC quite a lot yesterday because the Xbox services were down, like I said at the beginning of the video. And can we place that down here? Plant sign. Oh. Well, that's not how I wanted you to work, is it? No. Okay, so... pull signpost. Sure. I don't think it's gonna... Yep, I've just... Oh, no, never mind. I was gonna say I broke the sign, but no. Can we place it here? No. Okay, so we can't place it. Sorry, Kyle. Sorry, Alex. You're gonna have to stay on the floor. But we're gonna move these presents as well. But you know what? We keep getting off track. I said we're gonna go get these birch trees. We are gonna go get the birch trees because we need birch trees. We have none. That means we can't build our house. We need to build our house, which is a very important thing. There's a tree there, Tyler. And it's starting to become nighttime too, so I can't do this video for very long. I do have work later as well, though, so... Yeah. I'll have to go back to work, but I can guarantee you I will probably make another video later when I'm back, depending on what time I finish. I don't always finish on time, but... I'll make a video when I'm back, and when there's another day off, I will make loads and loads of videos, as long as the Xbox services are not out again. Which is, it was kind of a bummer for me as well, yeah. A lot of you people have been saying in my comments, oh, now Tyler's going back to Lumber Tycoon. No, I'm not. I'm not going back to Lumber Tycoon. Lumber Tycoon, it still has its issues, it still has... the hackers, it still has people, it still has exploiters, and it's just, there's not a team working on Woodmill, I mean working on Lumber. The thing that makes Woodmill so great is that there's a team working on it. There's a group of people, multiple opinions going into this project. It's like, this is like, when it comes to game development, this is the best you can get. Like, you've got an actual team working on the game. There's nothing better than you can get than a team rather than one person. Like, that's good. They've added so much new features. I've been here since the beginning. And I can tell you now, if you're new, you're going to find it a bit boring if you're new. But if you've been here since pre-alpha, if you've been here since the beginning, you'd realize that there is a lot of feature in this game. There is a lot of features, a lot of stuff to take advantage of. The map size is incredible. It is huge. It is literally better than Lumber Tycoon. And a lot of people don't like me saying that this game is better than Lumber Tycoon 2, but at the same time, it does have its faults too. Look at this. The wood does not want to stay on top of the car, and eventually it will fall off. So that's not a good thing. Obviously, Woodmill do have its bugs too, but it's nothing compared to the issues I've had with Lumber. People can't destroy... I've not had people destroy my base yet. I've had people steal off my base at the moment. But remember, the game is in pre-alpha. I mean, the game is in alpha. So stuff like that is expected. Bugs are expected to happen. Blacklist is not working. Not being able to drive your cars, wood not being able to stay on top of your car, other stuff like that. They will all be fixed in the future. But right now, the devs are currently working on it. They definitely want to prioritize bug fixing the game. That's what I know for sure. But a lot of people do agree with me that this game is currently shaping out to be better than Lumber. And in my opinion, it already is better than Lumber in its own ways. Lumber does have its own ways of me calling it better. Like I say, Lumber does have a lot more features, a lot more content, it's got a lot more items. So, to be fair, yeah, Lumber does have a lot more content, and it is better in that aspect. But when it comes to stability, when it comes to hacking, the main problems we have are hackers. The main problem I've had, I don't care about car glitches as much, because I can deal with them. You can just pick your car, you can just put your wood back on your car. But when it comes to a hacker coming and destroying your base, when you've got a base like mine on Lumber Tycoon, you really want to try and save it. I've tried my best, I've tried multiple times to protect my slot, and I've run out of ideas on how to protect it. My last idea was to add the glass. Great idea, Tyler. Nobody can use their axes to get the items off your shelves. Yes, that's a great idea, but when there's a hacker comes on and they're able to go through walls, that glass does nothing. So it was just pointless. So now I've just got it all in the glass, but I don't want to play the game because of hackers and stuff like that. Because my base is literally so good, it is became a target. So when people say to me, oh, I've said before, you guys will all come back to Lumber Tycoon. No, I'm not coming back. I was only just giving away items. And I'm pretty loyal when it comes to my stuff. Like, let's say Clash of Clans, for example. I've been in a clan for about 5 years. I'm loyal when it comes to stuff. I don't just follow the trends or anything. Like, this game, this is going to be a game that I play every day of my life now. This is going to be, as long as they update it, as long as it's not a waste of time, as long as they add more features. At the moment, it's okay, because it's an alpha, there's bugs. The devs have said, like, the devs are very social. They do speak to the community. Look at Defaultio. I mean, not hating or anything, but Defaultio didn't really speak to the community. Not that I'm aware of. I tried looking into the updates, he just didn't really speak to the community. People would be like, hey, my base has been wiped and I can't do nothing about it, or a hacker had wiped my base. I think Defaultio had just got asked too many times, and because he's on his own, he had enough. And I don't blame it. Why am I putting it back in the car for? This is me talking and being on a rant. But yeah, it's because Defaultio's on his own. He doesn't have the inspiration of other people. He doesn't have other developers to keep him going, like working with. But now Woodmill is here. Woodmill has basically inspirated Defaultio to work on Lumber Tycoon and add features again. He's fixing his game. Don't know if he's going to be adding features, but he is definitely fixing his game. Now, why would he be fixing his game? Well, two reasons. He could be literally, like, fixing the game for Halloween, so he could have a break after Christmas, because thinking about it, it's all becoming quite a little bit of a stressful planning period right now. If you're thinking about game development, you would have thought to start planning for Halloween, I'd say about a month ago, maybe 2 months ago. But just to make sure that the features that you add work for the first time. And then you're going to release it about a couple weeks beforehand for a couple tester players, just to make sure you don't have any problems with the items. And then what you're going to do is you're going to release it fully to everyone after, and then it's all good. But what the problem is, Defaultio currently, he doesn't have these tester people that I know of. He doesn't have specific, I don't think he has a Discord. I don't remember there being a Discord. I was in a Discord called Lumber Tycoon Fan Group or whatever, but I couldn't find one of his, so I just left it. And yeah. But yeah, Woodmill has a team of people. What I'm trying to say is Woodmill is not going to just stop updating the game anytime soon. They have like 4, 5, maybe 6 people on this game, whereas Lumber only has Defaultio. So development does take a long time, and he can lose interest pretty fast when it comes to developing. If he's got no competition, like if you think about it, all of these other games are just copying his game exactly, like the exact same map, Like, when I say exact same map, I don't mean the Woodmill old map. I mean the exact same map. I'm pretty sure there's a game out there called Lumber Tycoon Remastered. I've probably played it once, but from what I'm aware of, it's no good because I'm still not playing it. But there's other games that are just exactly the same map with a couple alterations, maybe a couple new trees that spawn, a new area on the map, or maybe, for example, 5,000 money instead of 20. It's exactly the same, and that doesn't give DefaultIO any reason to keep updating his game, to be honest, because if that was me, I would have been like, these people are all just copying me. There's no competition. I've just created the best game out there, and nobody is going to pull me up on that challenge. And to be honest, someone should pull them up, and Woodmill Inc. are currently the best competition. And I don't mean competition as in a bad way either. I mean good competition. Apple and Samsung, Fortnite and PUBG. I think it's PUBG or Warzone. But they are all competition, but they are not fighting against each other. You can say Woodmill and Lumber are the same thing. Yes, they're on Roblox. Yes, they look similar, but are the aspects of it the same? Are the maps the same? Does Lumber Tycoon have these archways? I know you can't see anything, but no, it doesn't. It really doesn't. But it's too dark for me to continue saying anything else. And the moon is only just rising, so it's going to be the end of this video. But if you guys agree with me on this, then let me know in the comment sections down below. And some of you guys need to just back off of my channel. If you guys are subscribed and you're like, hey, Tyler, I've told you before, you're going to quit Woodmill. No, I don't quit my games. I've even played Minecraft for over 13 years. It's like, I don't quit games, guys. Clash of Clans, 10 years plus. Minecraft, 10 years plus. Roblox, I know it just says I got the 20 day in a row achievement. That's probably because I've just managed to leave and live on my own. So I've been playing Roblox since this came out. I've been playing Minecraft since this came out. All the good games. I've been playing Lumber since it came out. Now I'm here on Woodmill. When it came out, what do you think I'm gonna do? I'm gonna stay with Woodmill. I'm obviously gonna go back to Lumber every now and then, because I just need a little switcheroony. I'm not gonna go play Adopt Me Simulator or anything, am I? But I'm not hating on it or anything. It's just not my style of game. But yeah, so if you did like this video, then make sure to leave a like and subscribe. I'm sorry I didn't get much done. I was kind of distracted halfway at the beginning of the video, talking to developers and changing my skin and just messing around. But hopefully this has informed some of my subscribers, if you're subscribed to me on the channel, which I recommend you do, that I'm not going to be quitting Woodmill, I'm not going to be quitting Lumber, but there will be less videos on Lumber purely because I want to save my base. And you know what? I'm going to go on Lumber right now, and I'm going to do a very, very, very old base design tour. You know what? I'm going to do that right now because it's nighttime. It's going to be like this for the next 20 minutes. It's going to be a 10-minute video, so I can do that. And then I'll edit the videos and upload it before I go to work in like 4 hours' time. So if you did like this video, then make sure to leave a like and subscribe. If you want to see more videos like this from me on the channel, then make sure to turn your notification bells on. I know Woodmill can be stressful at the moment. I know some of you guys don't want to play it because of the bugs, but trust me, the devs are working on it. The devs have lives too. The devs need some peace and quiet. So don't go at them being like, hey, your game is broken. That's my video's job. I mean, if you see a bug that's not in my video, then feel free to report it. But I think they watch my videos. So when I say there's a bug, I'm pretty sure they get the point. So it's not fair to just keep going on at them. Like, just assume. Like, if there's a bug and you think it's specifically for you, then feel free to tell them. But like I've done most of the time, I've just said in a video, but I've not gone to them and gone, hey, this, and this needs fixing. I've just gone in the video, that's broken, it'll be fixed, don't worry about it. That's what you guys should do, don't worry about it, it'll be fixed. Come back in a week's time, and you might have a fixed game. Come back in a month's time, you may have missed Alpha, but yeah. Anyway, guys, if you did like this video, then make sure to leave a like and subscribe. If you want to see more videos like this from me on the channel, then make sure to turn your notification bells on. And that's if you want to stay up to date with any videos that I upload on the channel. And I shall see you guys.